So let's talk about sort of planning for security. When we talk about security here, obviously we're talking about cybersecurity. So of course, the first thing you're going to ask is, you talked about what is of value, what are the assets, what needs to be secured? You've been asked to come in and plan, but the next thing you have to say is, if something has to be secured, whose responsibility is it to do that? So who is responsible for it? Okay, once we do that, the next thing then we're going to say, well, security is going to require some controls. Okay, so once you have that, you have to say, well, we know who's responsible for it. We know what kind of things they're doing or what controls they're putting in place, but are people really supported to do what they need to do? Do they have the budgets? Do they have the authority? And one thing to keep in mind is that no matter how well we do all these things that we're talking about, the risk is never going to be zero. So the chance or likelihood that something might go wrong, well, it's going to be there. And if something does go wrong, unfortunately, if that were to happen, how do we respond to that? How do we recover from that adverse event that has happened because some control either didn't exist or didn't function as it should have? And of course, if we had people who were responsible for doing certain things in our security planning that we did, and if something bad happens, there has to be accountability. So in the planning process, we always have to sort of keep in mind that we're never going to get 100% security. Okay, the risk is never going to be zero, so we have to worry about, we sort of focus on prevention, detection, but then of course we have to focus on response and recovery as well. And the planning process has to cover all those aspects.